We're all very pleased and delighted you could all come today. Looks like the rain has finally just blown over. We'll see some sunshine. And we're delighted that Sir David Attenborough has come officially to open the Nature Park and the Visitor Centre. It's been open, of course, for a year. Many people have enjoyed coming to the park already. And we're delighted that no one more esteemed than Sir David will be here to open this. Not least because for half a century or even a little bit more, you've brought wildlife from every corner of the world into our living rooms and cinemas and made that alive for us. Thurrock Tameside is a special park. It's the 87th of the Essex Wildlife Trust Nature Reserves. I guess a celebration when we reach 100, John, perhaps. One of eight visitor centres in the county of Essex. And they all epitomise to me the value of wildlife and nature in our neighbourhoods. Close by, around the corner, accessible, not just remote. And nature in this way is part of a living landscape, particularly in this part of the world, a living landscape where the wild is close by the industrial. There's something kind of special about this part of the world. And many of you will know that I walked 500 miles around the coast of Essex and Suffolk and Norfolk to write a book called This Luminous Coast. And in that, I described walking around the Mucking Tip, swirling with clouds of gulls and angry trucks roaring up and down the road to Linford. And look now, we've always been good at transformation in the landscape. Alive, if you will, that image of how this place once was for many decades and how that vision now looks today. A plug, if you're not yet a member of Essex Wildlife Trust, please do join. You just have to speak to one of these people with these badges on around the place and they'll sign you up if you want to. For it is the members, the hard work of the members and staff of Essex Wildlife Trust that have affected these kinds of transformations in the landscape. It really is remarkable what's been achieved. I want to say thank you to them all for doing that. So David Attenborough is President Emeritus of the Wildlife Trusts, and I'd like to ask him now to say a few words to open the park. Sir David.
Thank you very much, Professor Pitney, ladies and gentlemen. I have been lucky enough to spend the last few decades going around the world, and one of the saddest, most dreadful things I have seen is the appalling way in which human beings have transformed the land in which they live. Terrible things that they've done to the environment. A year ago, I was in a part of the Borneo rainforest that I knew well 30 years ago. Wonderful, rich in birds and insects and animals and reptiles. And what did I see? I saw a wasteland of oil palms. Nothing but oil palms. I've swum on reefs in Indonesia, coral reefs, which have been full of the most beautiful, wonderful fish and invertebrates you could imagine. And I've gone back and seen them dying under sludge. I've been to moorlands, which were wild, wonderful, empty places where you could hear the screech of hunting birds and feel the wind on your face. And what have I seen? A wasteland of oil derricks, as people are pumping out oil from the land beneath. But this place, is somewhere that's been created by the same power that human beings have in their hands, but not to destroy, but to bring to life. This site is a miracle for us all. All of us. suspect, every week see rubbish taken from our houses, or from the factories, or from the places where we work. And we have a little thought at the back of the mind. Where is that going to be dumped? What foul smell that we could smell, sense brewing in that, where is that going to burst onto the air? And most of us, I dare say, like me, tend to say to ourselves, least seen, you know, out of sight, out of mind. Well, where it came to was here. From six boroughs of London, it came here and was dumped with all the junk and the filth and the waste that we have chucked out of our houses. Not only us, but out of our factories. It was dumped here. This is one of the great landfill spaces, enormous landfill spaces where this stuff, and it lies beneath your feet right now. 20 meters deep, that rubbish lies beneath here. But by a miracle, not only a miracle, but by huge effort on the part of someone and some group, you put plastic on the top of that filth and that waste. You have put pipes that take the poisonous gas, the methane, from that rising, and which will go on rising for decades from this waste beneath here. And you've piped it to turbines where it can generate power. So it's not just waste, it's gone into being maybe productive. This land and the visitor centre over there, a revolutionary building, because you know that waste over the years will settle. So how do you put a building on it? Answer, that you put jacks underneath the building, so that as the building sinks and maybe tilts, we can, it can be adjusted to make sure that it sinks in a level way. A miracle of engineering and thought. So this site here, on the banks of what is going to be the greatest port in Western Europe, is a site to be hugely proud of. How has it been brought about? How is it that this dump of refuse has now become a green land where you can see peregrines, short-eared owls, hear skylarks? Where I live in Western London, I haven't heard a cuckoo in years. There are cuckoos here and skylarks. What a joy. How's this bond brought about? By you, ladies and gentlemen, led by the Essex Wildlife Trust. What a joy and what an achievement that the Trust has brought about. It has got money and funds from all over the place, from government, from quarry industries, from other parts of industries, from various funds that have been set up to help in reclamation. But a lot of it has come from you, members of the Trust. And if you'll allow me just one personal mention, I served 25 years ago on the Nature Conservancy Council with a remarkable man, a marvellous, vigorous man who farmed around here. His name was Hugh Watt, and he is characteristic of the public welfare that people keep in their minds to produce places like this. So you are hugely to be congratulated because you have brought this miracle about. And you have brought it about led by the Essex Trust. And the Essex Trust has been led for the last 25 years by a remarkable, far-sighted, energetic man, John Hall. If you aren't already engaged in
this nature park under the December. And I want you to raise the roof of this mast in. Are you ready? So David, thank you so much for coming today. Hip, hip!
Hooray!
Hip, hip!
Hooray!
Go for it! Hip, hip!
Hooray!
I assure you, it's not only a great treasure, it's a real privilege. What has been done here is a monument. It could be a turning point. Good luck to you all.
Absolutely fantastic. I mean, in spite of the weather, there's been an immense turnout here, and I think that reflects both the quality of this project and, of course, the reputation of Sir David Attenborough.
It certainly ticks all my boxes. There's a great sense for the environment. It's a great place to walk and enjoy it and cycle in this beautiful park. And of course, there's the preservation of fisheries as well. So I'm really impressed. It's been a wonderful day.
Do you think enough people know about it yet?
I think word's slowly getting out. Essex Wildlife Trust deliberately aimed to start slow. They wanted to give the volunteers time to get familiar with operating the centre. They recognise that everything here is still at an early stage of development, but I think today will represent a step change forward. I don't know how many people have been in this marquee, but they're all now going to go away and tell their friends. And I think the Trust will get exactly what they wanted, which is a gradual start, and after which it just builds and builds and builds.
It's a well-kept secret that I think now we've got a couple of thousand people here to spread the word of how good this place really is.